Welcome to WebStylePress. If you are new here, consider subscribing and hit bell icon. We have shared toggle and accordion videos including simple toggle, slide toggle, simple accordion and slide accordion. What if you want to use multiple toggles or accordions at same page? Will you write as many functions as many accordions are there? Nope. Single function can work for multiple elements separately. You just have to target elements properly. Do not target global selector for elements. Use this keyword in parallel with closest and find. If you are using jQuery, this will hold element that was clicked, and then we can get its closest wrapper and do stuff only inside it. To demonstrate it, I will recreate all four snippets and will use multiple of them at same page. In this process, we will verify that our function is working for even copies of toggles and accordions at same page. I will not explain code here because I have already created individual videos for all four of these. I will link those in description. We will only verify that function is working properly for each of these when these are duplicated. In my example, I have got index.html, custom.scss. Output for this custom.scss will be .css file that will be thrown. I am using an extension in Visual Studio Code that will convert this scss file into css file. And I have got custom.js. These are my files in same folder. I have got HTML template. I have linked Bootstrap with it and I have linked Font Awesome with it. These are CDN links. And I have linked custom.css file with this document. And at the bottom I have got jQuery and I have got custom.js. I have created a template. This is using Bootstrap, container, raw, and then half column, and then half column. Our first example was this. HTML for that was this. So it's a toggle wrap, and inside it, there are blocks of elements. Toggle block, and then toggle block. Inside toggle block, we have got a title and then a content to toggle. Save. This is the output right now. We will apply CSS. Here is the CSS for it. Toggle block, it will have a border bottom, and then it will have a color, and then toggle trigger. Toggle trigger is our title. This toggle trigger, it will be clicked, and then this div will be toggled. So the title is cursor pointer position. Relative, it has got padding, it has got margin, and then for its pseudo after element, we have got a font awesome element. Font awesome 5's element, it is a arrow. And then this is toggleable. Toggleable is the div that will be toggled. It is displayed none, it will not be shown from start, and then it has got a padding. And this active, if this toggle dash blog will have a class active, then it will have a darker color for its text inside it. And then for its toggle trigger, font awesome icon will change, the arrow will change, that's the whole story. And I have saved it. This is the output for the CSS. On click of title, this active class will be toggled, and that will determine the style for certain part of our snippet. For our JavaScript, this is the function just toggle. I will use document.ready function, and then inside it I will trigger this function. So at the start, something is happening. First toggle dash block is receiving class active, and for the first toggle dash block we are finding toggleable inside it, the div, and we are toggling it when this function is getting triggered. So first element is opening, class is being added, and its toggleable div is opening or being displayed. And then toggle trigger is our title. At its click, we are finding its closest toggle block, and we are toggling class active at it. Similarly, at toggle trigger click, we are looking at the closest toggle dash block for this toggle trigger, and then we are finding toggleable inside this toggle block, and then we are stopping the propagation of script, and then we are toggling that. That is the script. So our CSS is complete, JS is complete, and this is the script output. So it is just the toggle. So now the question is, if I duplicate this, will this work? This is the whole block. We are duplicating it. Refresh. Now these are two. Okay, so this block is working perfectly fine. And it is also working fine. So both are working fine. So its copy is also working fine with same script. I can copy these two columns and create more duplicates. Reload page. And they're all working fine. So our toggle is working. I will comment this function now, and this as well. So let's proceed. In fact, I will comment this as well. And paste it here. In fact, let's remove the second. Okay, now we want to slide toggle it. CSS will be same, function will be different. Just slide toggle. Let's try get this function. Reload. And now it is slide toggle instead of just toggle. And what if we duplicate it? Copy and then paste. Now we have two of these. This one is working, and then this one is also working individually. It is not affecting this one, right? So we will comment this as well. And we will comment this function. Now let's proceed with third. Third one is accordion. CSS for it will be different. Let's comment this CSS and then proceed next. This is the CSS for recording. Almost the same. And then for the function, this is just accordion, not sliding accordion. We will try get this function and the output will be this one. So this is accordion. One block is visible at a time, other closes if you click at some other title. So if we duplicate it, copy, paste, reload, so these are working individually. One is not affecting the other. So this is also working. I will use same CSS will be same, function will be different. This time we will slide, we will create sliding accordion. This is the function. This will be commented accordion slide. Will be triggered here when DOM will be ready. And let's see. And now this is accordion, but it is sliding. And what if we have got copy of it? And here is the copy, duplicating it. And this one is working. And this one is also working. And it is not affecting the other. So you can create toggle or accordion, and then you can create its duplicate, and you can replicate it as many times as you like. And now it is using single function. Function is one, there is single function behind it, but it will work for all of the accordions that are at the same page. This is what we were verifying today, and it is because of this closest and then this find, closest find, closest find. We have used closest and find everywhere. Okay, we did not do it like jQuery block dot siblings. We targeted it at click of this, its closest block siblings, remove class, its closest block siblings, find content, stop and then slide up. So this does the magic, closest and find. See this trigger, trigger is this one, this is being clicked, and then its closest is block. We're telling it to look at its closest block. So at its click, its closest is this block, only this block. And then we are finding find dot content, then we are finding content inside it. At its click, closest block, find content inside it, and then toggle or slide up or whatever. So this is the magic, closest and find. Closest is nearest wrapper, and find will find something inside that block, only that block. So this is the magic. That concludes our tutorial. I will link the previous tutorials in the description, so go check them out as well. I hope you liked this video. If I missed anything, comment down below. If you haven't already subscribed, subscribe to this channel and hit bell icon to receive updates. Join us on social media. Links are in the description below. Stay tuned for more updates. I will see you in the next video.